Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. In today's video I'll be showing you how can you make your own can shaker machine. The purpose of this machine is to shake a can of spray paint more evenly when it's time to paint something like a case for example. And with a timer built in it will be easy to set up and set when it's done. Just pick up the can and we'll be ready for painting without having too much or too little coming out of the nozzle. So without further speaking, I start by first grabbing an Arduino Nano from my stash. And also a few other components like some momentary switches, then some 2.1mm barrel type connector, plus some toggle switch, a relay, some header pin for the Arduino, and a 16x2 LCD display, and a Vero board. After getting all the components required for this project, I have grabbed my caliper prior to measure the component footprint, and I start making the case for it. The case was being modeled in 1-to-3D design, and then it was up to the printer to finish it off. With the case ready, it's time to put the circuit together, partially, according to this schematic which is now in front of you. With the circuit built, it was time for the Arduino code, and here I have to say that the code has been borrowed from an already existing similar project, and after just altering few lines of code, I have uploaded it on my Arduino Nano. And this part is done, the next was to add everything to the freshly created box, and the controller side is done for this machine. The next step was to make out the frame. For that I have 10x10x1mm square tube. First was to grab a ruler and a sharpie and mark 2 points on a 25cm length and process by cutting it. After the 2 pieces was cut, I have marked 3 points of about 50cm in length and cut them as well with the jigsaw. These are just few parts of the machine. In the end, the bottom side of the can mixer is done, and the only thing remaining is just to rough out the corners using a file. After that I went in 1-to-3D design and created some 2D corners with 3 anchor points. After that I fed it out to the printer and here they are. With the aluminum square ready, I have started assembling the frame by first marking the holes and after they was drilled using a 3mm drill bit. Then I have used some M3 screws with nuts and washer to bolt it down momentarily. And also some small rubber legs which will help reduce the machine noise while running. And with some light touches the base is ready. After that I have designed another type of 2D corners but this time with 4 anchor points. This will be going to link the entire frame. But still more holes have to be drilled and chamfered. Here is the first side done and also the second side. They will be playing a very important role as they will increase the stability and also the ruggedness of the machine. And the reason that's why the screws have been bolted upside down is purely so have some anchor points and possibly I'll be shifting them upright when all the parts of the machine will be done in place. But still, even with the frame nearly done, I have to add some aluminium flat bar, which have to be cutted at about 27cm. After marking the aluminium flat bar, I start cutting them, and after I got 2 pieces. I have also start drilling some 3mm holes, in total 8 for each bar. And afterwards bolted it down to the bottom of the frame using some machine flat top screws. Then with the platform complete it's time to attach the module. I have designed and printed some hinges. for the module display. After I grab some leftover 10x10x1mm square tube, I mark about 10cm in length of it with a sharpie and drill the two holes, first with a 3mm drill bit, after I follow that up with a 5mm drill bit. In the end, I cut the bar and round off the edges with a file, looking decent enough, I guess. Now the arm was done is simply using also some machine screws, but a bit longer, and as well some spacer between the hinges. On the bottom side, I grabbed some washers to offer a decent grip, while it can still be adjusted with less force, as seen here. With the module attached, it start looking like something. The only thing remains to make is the can mixer, or better, the shaker. The first part is to make a sweeping arm. For that, a flat bar has to be cut at about 24 cm in length, and with the help of a sharpie, I have marked at a line at 2.5 cm. Then the two little marks where the two holes will be drilled using a 3mm drill bit. I have made a groove with my handsaw and bent it prior to install it to the frame. But before doing that, few more holes have to be drilled and chamfered. As example, from the base at a point of 3cm, a hole has to be marked and drilled. Its purpose is for holding this gear, which I have designed and printed beforehand. With the hole drilled, I grabbed two small 11x5mm ball bearing, and then I grabbed some washer and a 5mm bolt to secure the main gear onto the flat bar. And it's turned out decent enough with the main gear on its place. Then I grab another flat bar, which have to be marked at 13.5 cm and then cut it. Few more holes have to be drilled afterwards. Like one for another 11x5 bearings, which have to be for the arm to have a pivot point. Then the two holes are for this can carriage attachment, more on that in a bit. And one which will be for connecting the main flywheel gear to the rolling pivot cage. I have added next the top ball bearing, and then was the first half of the carriage as you see in here. It's quite big, but it's necessary for the different spray can kind of there. The carriage mechanism is quite simple in its own words, and also was not hard to design it. Then was to the printer to make it, and here it is. It's consisting of two parts, one which will be bolted onto the carriage and it will be stationary, while the other side will be having the two long bolts in combination with some springs and some washer. It's quite simple and practical. And the second part, which has to be moved in and out when the can is attached or detached from the machine. With that sorted, it's time for the motor. For the motor, at the beginning I was having a look of what I got already. And after some iteration and some attempts in making a simple gearbox using some old gears from a power tools, I have noticed that the first installment or the gearbox of a planetary gearbox, to be more precise, can compare hand with the demand. In some way it works, but it has some overheating issue. Second attempt was to use a simple gearbox made from spur gears, and it has some potential, but due to the high RPM of the motor, it's quite loud, and as well I don't think it will last too much. So in the end I have designed to go with a different type of motor, more specifically this one which has already gearbox attached to it. This one it is a 370 type motor with a gear reduction box of roughly 200 RPM at 12 volts. And after designing some simple model which will be for mounting the motor onto the frame, the model was done as well in 1D design and printed like usually using PLA White Plus. The motor clamp is done, and also I have printed off camera another wheel with the same number of two to keep the same RPM. They look like an engine twin cam. Then I have mounted the motor onto the frame. But before securing the motor, I have grabbed an old bike inner tube and cut it some pieces which will be for bracing between the motor and the clamp. The purpose of it will be for dampening the noise and suppress the vibration from the motor. Then I got some longer screws and bolted down using some washers and nuts. And here it is, the can shaker work as expected. And the last thing which has to be done is to grab some CV moly and grease it with a little brush, the entire mechanical assembly. And adding the cable from the motor as well. And the can shaker is done. This video has come to an end. I hope you have learned something interesting today, and I shall see you all in the next video. Till then, have a nice day and thank you very much for watching. See ya!